Hello students, let us continue the lesson Jamaican fragment. Now we'll start the textbook. Every day I walk a half mile from my home to the rail track lines in the morning and from the lines to my home in the evening. Now here the author says, now he is also a black African, sorry, Jamaican. He is also a black Jamaican. Every day he used to walk a half mile from his home to the railway track lines in the morning and from the lines to his home in the evening. He liked walking there. The walk is pleasant. Why he liked walking? It was a pleasant time. You can see on either side red and green roofed bungalows, green lawns and gardens. The exercise is good for me and now and then I learn something from a little incident. The author says that it will be pleasant to have a walk from his home to the railway track on the other side, and because he could see on either sides there was a red and green roofed bungalows, green lawns and gardens. So, and it was also a exercise for him. And like that, one morning about halfway between my front gate and the rail track, I noticed two boys playing in the garden of the more modest cottages. Once on his way back while walking, there was a front gate and the railway track. He noticed two boys playing in the garden of more modest cottages. Not modest means not so expensive. They were both very little boys. Two boys were playing some game. He was noticing, he watched them play. They were both very little boys. One was 4 years old perhaps, the other 5. The bigger of the two was a sturdy youngster, very dark, with a mat of coarse hair on his head and coal black eyes. See, the bigger one, the bigger of the two, both were sturdy and strong. They looked strong. The bigger of the two was a sturdy youngster, strong and firm. And he was very dark with a mat of coarse hair. You have seen the picture now. They had a curly hair. So they are dark with a mat of coarse hair, bushy curly hair on his head and coal black eyes. They have coal black eyes. Now he was definitely a little Jamaican, strong little Jamaican. He was a Jamaican. The other little fellow was smaller but also sturdy. The other little fellow, how does he look? He was white with hazel eyes and little brown hair. He was white and with hazel eyes. Hazel eyes means reddish brown eyes. With reddish brown eyes, and he has a little light brown hair. Both were dressed in blue shirts and khaki pants. They dressed uniformly. They wore no shoes and their feet were muddy. They didn't wear any shoes and they were playing in the mud. They were not conscious of my standing there watching them. They played on. Yes, they didn't notice the author there. The game, if it could be called a game, was not elaborate, not a long lengthy one. The little white boy, what did they play? What game they played? The author was watching. The little white boy walked majestically up and down and every now and then shouted in a commanding tone at his bigger playmate. The little brown boy dragged on quietly behind him and did what he was told. Yes, now usually even you when you were a child, you will also have played, right? Like a teacher students game, like that you will be commanding the students. The students will be listening to the teacher, like holding a stick. You might have played, right? The same way, the little white boy. See, among those two, the little white boy walked majestically in an impressive way, like a master, up and down, and every now and then shouted in a commanding tone at his bigger playmate. See, one of the boys, he walked majestically up and down, and he was giving order to them. Other boy, he was commanding to the other boy. The little brown boy, he was a Jamaican boy, dragged on quietly behind him and did what he was told. He was obeying his orders. He was obeying his orders. He did whatever he said he used to do. So let's see what happens next. How the author watched next. Let's end up the lesson here. We'll continue in the next class. Thank you.